Welcome to Finding Faith in the Outdoor, When Jesus Comes to Deer Camp. I'm excited to have you guys with me. I hope you enjoy this series and kind of see and learn some of the things that I have learned and God has shown me through my years of hunting and being in the outdoors. So I want to start this with a really, really basic first question. Are you a hunter? And actually, that was a trick question, because yes, you are. Everyone is a hunter. Everyone is searching for something. That is a universal human condition. People are searching for love. They're searching for a career. They're searching for a family, wealth, fame, recognition, acceptance. I mean, it goes on and on and on. Everyone has what I call a God-shaped hole in their heart. And universally, we try to fill that. And unfortunately, a lot of people try to fill that God-shaped hole with different things. And there's only one thing that fits there. That's Jesus. And that's the only thing that's going to, you know, fill that hole and fill that universal kind of longing. But many people don't know that. So everyone is looking for something. It's kind of our humanness, or the human condition, is that universal void. So to hunt means to search for something. That's all it means, to go and look for something. And the first verse I want to talk about is Deuteronomy 4:29. But if from there you seek the Lord your God, you will find him if you seek him with all your heart and all your soul. And that explains the whole thing I was just talking about, is we all need to be searching for God and seeking God. And if this sounds like a big game of, you know, biblical hide and seek, it's really not. God isn't that hard to find. It's not him that's lost. He's not hiding. It's us that lost, and it's us that are blind. But he gave us the perfect roadmap, or the perfect GPS, if you will, and that's Jesus Christ. Jesus shows us the way to God. Jesus is, in fact, the only way to God and is the path to God. And he teaches us through how he lived as a man, and through his sacrifices, the way to God and the way to behave. And he teaches us some habits, and we're going to get into those habits later. But Jesus is the way to God, and that makes him so much harder to find. So back to the question, are you a hunter? And I already said the answer is yes. So let's follow up with another question: can you hunt? And now I'm talking about, can you go out in the woods and take game and take the life of an animal? And that becomes a really more personal question. And I don't think anyone knows that until they go do it. Later on in the series, we'll talk about some of the morals and ethics of hunting. Hunting for food, and do we have to do it anymore? And we'll cover a bunch of those type of things. But I will tell you this, that I don't think anyone knows for sure until you come to that moment. And I'm going to share a personal story with me. So I have been hunting for a long, long time. My dad took us out deer hunting. I think we were probably 13 or 14 years old when we first started. And I didn't know much. It took me a long time to learn. And I actually hunted until I was 26 years old. So about 13 years I hunted without ever taking a big game animal. And so I didn't really know. And kind of fast forward to, I think it was 1999, I went on a bear hunt in Canada. And this is the first time I went, you know, beyond hunting in the backyard and out in the, you know, farms. And I didn't know. And, you know, we drove all the way up to Canada. And there's a couple things, and we're going to cover these things later on in the series. But I really, really practiced really hard. I wanted to make sure that, you know, I did everything right. And so we had hunted for a couple days. We saw lots of bears. And I think it was the third day. I was off in an area kind of by myself. And I was sitting alone, and I was praying. And I can't remember, probably in my whole life, I always prayed when I hunting. And we'll talk about that in great detail later too. But I was praying, and kind of it was quiet, and it was a beautiful day in the woods. And I looked up, and there was a bear. And I had bought a new rifle just for this trip, and so I raised up my rifle and I looked through the scope, and my heart was just beating and beating and beating. And I didn't know, and I had that thought, you know, I don't know if I can do this or not. And I set the crosshairs on the, you know, the vital section, and closed my eyes, and I prayed, and I'm like, I don't know if I can do this. And I kind of came to the realization, I don't care. This isn't defining me or anything. If I do it or not, that's not really the point of it. And we will talk about that quite a bit. But I opened my eyes, I set the scope, and I pulled the trigger. And I ended up harvesting that bear. That was the first big game animal. And it was in that moment that I realized that I can do this, and I can take my part of this cycle of, you know, sustenance. And that's really what hunting is about. It's first thing, the reality is that life eats life. That's how it works. That's how we get the calories we need for sustenance, is we break down components from either vegetables or animals, and both are alive. So that's how biology works. That's how God made it. That's the way it was meant to be. But to take an active role in that, something, by the way, everyone used to do, that was the way it was done. People slaughtered their own animals. They raised them. They slaughtered them. People hunted. People gathered. That's just, you know, supermarkets are a new thing. But, you know, I took part in that, and to me, that was really, really cool. And I've been, you know, hunting ever since. But it doesn't really matter whether you think you can do this or not, or even really morally, whether you think that that's okay or not, because this series is not really about killing. This is about hunting, and this is about my experiences and what God has shown me and taught me through my time in the outdoors. If you recall, every time that Jesus really, really wanted to get busy and get down to prayer, he went outside. He went to the outdoors. He went to the mountains. He went to the forest. He went off by himself in nature, in seclusion, to pray. And that is exactly absolutely is the number one reason I hunt, is to get my time and my quiet time with God. I guess it's my prayer closet, just that I measure my prayer closet in acres, not square feet. But it's a wonderful time for me. So I look forward to taking you through this. I actually have a workbook called When Jesus Comes to Deer Camp that I'll be going through, the same type of thing. I have all kinds of really great video I've taken while hunting. Some I've taken, some Rachel's taken, some other folks have. But I think we're going to have a really great time, and we're going to learn a lot. So I hope you keep watching these, and hopefully I'll have the next one up soon. Thanks. And I am yours. What does that make?